Let's get started. Welcome to the Forum Thread podcast. Be sure to tweet at us at the Forum Thread and leave your love in the Twitch chat for those of you that are in the Twitch chat. I am Wadabra, and here with me today, I have these lovely people. I have the consistent Chaos Mana.
Hi.
I have the party man, Zach45.
Yo, yo, yo.
I have the much-hated Nobod.
Not that hated.
Much hated. And our special guest, adding racial diversity and instilling fear into the people of Civilization V, the Mestri Jedi Mal.
Hello, people. Nice to meet you all.
Alrighty. So I have for us today the opening topic.
I was just about to introduce that. Thanks for stealing my
thunder. Pornhub space program. Sexploration. It's a Indiegogo campaign. I'll post it in the chat. It's an Indiegogo campaign for $3,400,000 to get two people into space and film a porn.
How do I sign up?
I'm okay with this.
See? There's the page right there.
Yes. They didn't choose the best candidates, aww, but, you know, someone would watch it.
Now, wait, so are they raising money to send... I can't click on the link because my computer sucks. Oh. Are they raising money to send people into space, or are they hoping that people can fork over enough money to send themselves into space for sex?
No, it's so send... to send. It's like a group fund project to create... send the two porn stars into space to film.
Yes, they're already set porn stars, and if they chose better porn stars, they'd probably have the money already, but they didn't choose.
Right now, as of 12 hours in, they've raised 2,990 of the millions of dollars.
Well, okay.
But they're not going to make it.
That's not so bad.
That's not at all, actually.
If you consider...
Well, it's also, you have to... consider it's going to take a long time for, well, not maybe not, I don't know.
No, like some video games that go to Kickstarter, like, raise the amount of money that they need to have, like, the day of the
hour of,
yeah, or the hour of the release. Like, if it's been
Sharknado
half of a day since its inception and they've only, like, made a few thousand dollars, it's not looking good.
The funny thing is, it's about two of people's favorite things: porn and space.
This is true.
Yeah, zero gravity porn.
Yeah, zero gravity porn. Here's my thing. Wouldn't it just be cheaper to fake it? You know,
I mean, but they want the experience. Like,
Like.
Also, who's to say that they wouldn't fake it? Even if they got the money and then keep the money. It's like, oh, we were totally in space,
they
guys.
They just use CG instead.
Exactly.
Really good.
They could, like, just use a million of the $3 million and then make the CG version a lot better.
But, you know, I'm sure there's like half the people who donate, like, they're just curious about...
I would be curious to see what they would do with something like that.
I'm curious to how they would actually do this. Okay, so in space, you obviously don't have much gravity. So, like, if you're brushing your teeth, you know, you have to wash your hair with dry shampoo because you're going to have little, like, water bubbles blobbing around.
Oh, that'd be right if the girl was
so,
a squirt.
Exactly,
okay.
Exactly. You know where I'm going with this. Like, so if,
interesting.
For porn,
so she's
going
to be nice and dirty.
So, okay, so they have some...
just water and, just sexy juices everywhere, basically.
You'll be floating in a stew of your own love juice.
One of the frequently asked questions is, how does one have sex in anti-gravity?
Well,
that's what we're hoping to find out.
Just use monkey bars.
No, but yes, it's physically possible, according to our research.
Well, right now, the way that they do it, or at least that they're going to do it, I saw this really cool... I don't know if it was a TED Talk or whatnot, but it was... they actually made this these vests that open in the front, and they velcro together, so you can velcro yourself to your partner and then get it on
that
without floating around.
Lame. Well, for porn,
yeah,
that would make lame. That would be the worst. So what they're gonna do,
you just see them kind of wiggling against each other, but you can't actually see anything.
They're gonna do monkey bars. They're gonna do monkey bars. Okay, so like, the guy's gonna hold monkey bars with his arms, and then there's a lady who's gonna be holding.
But they'll have
the
to
monkey
do something
bars
with
his
feet,
arm,
like,
her arms.
There's no gravity to pull their bodies down, so they have to, like, have their feet shackled to
the
floor.
Yeah, Well, no, she's just gonna shackle his feet to his hips and midsection, and then they're just gonna do, you know, like their own thing.
His so is this satisfying feet? Fetishes and curiosity?
Her feet are gonna lock around his waist.
Okay, I heard his feet, and I was confused for a minute.
I'm sorry, I'm kind of under the weather, so if I sound weird or improper, that's probably why. But yeah, it's gonna involve some monkey bars, maybe a jungle gym, and they're just gonna hold on and do their thing, man. Like, it's, you know.
How is the weather? How is the weather that you're underneath?
Not too good. I wanted to shoot myself in the head because I had such a terrible headache.
Hopefully you chose life.
You won't be able to have sex, though, so...
Exactly.
Or in space.
Exactly. So I chose life, and I took some cold medicine, and now I feel great.
That's a good idea.
It must be really good cold medicine.
How great do you feel?
Dude, I feel good. I got a great girlfriend. You know, I'm getting my life together. It's nice.
Sound like you're bragging.
I am.
Is it bragging or factual?
Apparently Zach already sounds like he's broadcasting from space.
Yeah,
Zach has a girlfriend. The Master Jedi Mal has a girlfriend. David's got a wife. What do you have, Nobod?
He has his name.
Legends.
I was mean.
I said his hand, and I was gonna go ba-dup-dup, but up, you know.
So it looks like Nobod, you and I are the only two people that don't have girlfriends. But
I get it. I get it.
Hey.
That makes me feel a lot better, Dark. Thank you.
I'm glad it does.
We broke Zach.
You already made him cough.
You guys can't make me laugh too bad. Like, I'll die.
Oh, I'm sorry. You came to the wrong place.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, I just wanted to read through some of the bigger perks that you would get if you actually donated to this.
Oh, if you donated?
Yes. They always have those. Tell me.
Yes. Hmm. Okay, so start at $1. You just get a little certificate. Yeah, $10 gets you early access to the video. $20 is a special donors only Q&A. It keeps on getting like exponentially. And then $25 is an HD copy of the film.
Ooh. HD sex.
Along with a couple stickers.
Ooh. What?
$50 is a 1 week subscription to one of the porn stars' exclusive websites. The next one is $100, and we got an entire bag of stuff from DVDs to stickers, T-shirts.
To more practical items?
Yeah, basically.
Oh, okay.
The next one, $200, earns you a hand-signed copy of the tape.
It's a hand-signed flesh.
Wait, is that what it says? A hand-signed copy of the tape? Like, they're planning on...
Yeah, a $200 contribution earns you a hand signed copy of the first ever sex tape made in space.
Okay.
Let's say sex tape because that's the terminology.
Yeah, sex tape makes sense, but if you just say tape, I'm like, wait a minute, they actually refer to it as tape.
Yeah, we had to use film.
Everybody needs to be able to watch
it. If you get $500, you get a signed copy, signed photo of one of the porn stars, plus a shout out during the filming of the sex tape, which will appear on the reel.
Excuse
no,
me?
I want a shout
out. She's gonna like say the wrong name.
Bloopers of the sex tape, they'd say like Mr. Fusion.
Yeah.
Okay, no guacamole. Oh my god, can someone put their name as Eucalyptus?
Why?
Just yells Eucalyptus.
I think that's like the least attractive or sexual word
in the human English language?
Yeah, the linguish English language.
Not that unattractive.
You got honestly. $1,000, which will get you a phone call from one of the porn stars.
What?
Porn.
During coitus?
That sounds terrible.
During coitus?
That's the real question.
$5,000 gets you a private lunch date with either of the porn stars.
That also sounds terrible.
Ooh, what are we eating?
Can you just imagine this? It's like, okay, so once the thing's done, it's like, you're like, so, you know some creepy person is going to be the one that donates that much money just so that they can, like, have a phone call with him. You're like, so hi, I'm the porn star, and then the other person's gonna be like, oh,
this is suddenly
a talk dirty line. What are you wearing?
Hey, listen, if they spent 50 whatever grand or 10 grand...
$5,000, you'd want at least something.
Yeah.
No, but job, the type of people that do that would be so gross, and it's like porn stars, they work like everybody else. Like, they're still people. They are clean people, too. They're very clean.
Nah,
sure they are.
They get into their own... Like,
I
listen,
would not want to hang out with
thing.
The creeper. Ew, no.
Well, what do you expect? Ugh. That's the industry. That's sort of nice. Not
the
as
industry,
good as Lo Zelda's burps, but...
I know.
Yeah.
I wish Lo Zelda was here. She would show us how to do it right.
Now we're going into the super big money... $10,000 gets you tickets to the exclusive industry-only sex tape launch party, as well as your name immortalized in the end credits.
Wait, so this launch party, is that like,
is it a literal launch party?
Is
or
that like
in,
when you see like
one of the space
missions where they're talking to Houston, like, you know, they're people at the computers and everything, but instead of like there being Houston and a bunch of people on computers, it's a whole bunch of people in a room watching the porn happen. Is that what they're talking about?
Like the launch,
Houston, we have a problem.
It's like a live streaming of the porn from space.
Exactly.
Yes.
Like, if I had that much money, I would screw having lunch with them, screw having a phone call. Like, if I had that much money, I'd be like, yes, I want to watch them do this live in space and watch them, like, fumble all over each other. And it would be
No one said in the chat, like, it'd be funny to watch the bloopers, them trying to do it, and then the guy just, like, floats off and is like, wait, come
Oh, yeah, God, like, the forces...
Come back, I'm still horny.
The force is going to be... It's going to be amplified, so like when he finally jizzes, like, he would probably launch him.
Oh, how cool would that be? How cool.
Just have this little stream of cum floating in the air.
Oh my gosh. No, I just imagined that, like, that instead of a jet propulsion to fly you around the ship, you just use that.
Semen.
That'd be exhausting.
Powered by semen.
The real question is, since it never stops, will it just go on in space forever and ever and, like, be perfectly frozen semen?
No, because this would be indoors, dumbass. Yeah.
They need
to
let it out.
Yeah.
No.
Let it be.
Because then people would be dead, and it would not be sexy anymore.
Well,
I have a question.
I have another question.
Once said launch semen is launched, would that, if that hit somebody, would it hurt? Like,
probably not.
Aw.
Well, I don't know.
Wait,
it depends on
why
squirting.
Would you want it to hurt?
Well, it'd be funny if you could use your semen as a projectile based weapon. Like, someone has a helmet on, and then you're like, and then you shoot your load off into their face, and it breaks their helmet, and they die.
No, you know, like, most people don't squirt that fast. Like, I think the average is like 30 something miles an hour. Like, it would be enough to be like, ugh, but.
It would be enough to, like, propel you a bit, but not enough to kill somebody.
Yeah, it'd be like someone just throwing something at you, and you'd be like, why'd you do that? Stop it.
Ah, fair enough. Okay. My dreams have died.
Of weapon-based semen?
Yes.
Yeah,
the perfect crime.
No. That's how people get caught on CSI all the time. There's semen everywhere.
Yeah, you're right. It takes me to, like, a Dave Chappelle joke where he was talking about, like, how forensics finds everything.
Damn forensics!
Yeah. Yep.
Destroying crime everywhere.
Yep.
Destroying
Ruining
semen everywhere for the sake of crime.
So, exactly.
Okay, so speaking of, well, it's kind of a stretch. Forensics, genetics, that type of thing. Did anybody see the new Jurassic Park movie, the Jurassic World movie?
It's out?
Yeah,
didn't it open today? Didn't it open today?
God damn.
Whoa.
I want to see that so bad.
Go see it now. After
I didn't see it today. I forgot about it until Malcolm reminded me of it earlier, and I'm like, shit, I'll probably go see that tomorrow. So I think I'm going to go see it tomorrow before I go to work.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to whore myself out so I can get a ticket at work so I can
Seems
see
like
it
the best
work.
Thing to do.
It's the only sensible thing to do.
Yeah.
It's only logical.
Okay, yeah. So no one's seen it, but... So
Harry Potter seen it?
So
no, I have not.
We all know how I feel about the movie, but let's on an unrelated note, I read something really interesting this morning, and it kind of reminded me of the whole Jurassic Park thing. It's about dinosaurs. So scientists may have found red blood cells in a 75 million year old dinosaur fossil.
Oh yeah, I saw that somewhere.
Now, like back in 2005, a scientist had found soft tissue, which is like collagen and other like connective tissues inside a T-Rex fossil, and they got some DNA from it and everything. And that's when they were like, "Oh yeah, T-Rex has some stuff in common with frogs, some stuff in common with chickens, and some stuff in common with other stuff." And then it's got some stuff that we don't even know what it belongs to. But this is like the first time they think they actually have found like real like blood inside of a fossil. Yeah, I thought, so that's pretty fucking cool.
It is pretty freaking cool. Like, with enough blood, they could actually get a viable DNA source. Like, that'll be cool.
They could actually create their own Jurassic Park.
No, well, they're not talking. The article.
Oh, we should definitely do it. Let's kill the world.
Did not. Was like, no, this isn't about like trying to clone dinosaurs. Like, we can't even. Oh, we're having trouble enough trying to clone woolly mammoths. Okay, and we actually have those mummified. No, they're actually talking about just being able to map their genetics and seeing how evolution, you know, their evolution worked, and like getting more insight
so
into how they lived.
So we're unlocking more pathways, basically.
Yeah, because like we all know that like, birds are the direct descendants of the bipedal dinosaurs now. Like technically, birds are dinosaurs. But how they got from, you know, T-Rex to pigeon
to chicken,
is a really interesting and fascinating thing. So being able to actually get a sample of that genetic material.
Okay. So maybe not really full-size T-Rex, but if they're like, hey, we could clone 1/100th of a T-Rex, so basically it'd be like 1/100th to scale, so it'd be the size of maybe like a modem or like
totally
two coffee cans or something.
It would still eat you, though.
Wouldn't that be fucking cool?
A teacup T-Rex?
It'd be worth it.
Wait, what?
Yes. It,
like, you get a couple of them, you throw them out in the yard, and they catch lizards and rats for you. That'd be great.
Yes.
And they still try to eat you?
You could film, like, a miniature, like, you could use Lego people and film, like, a miniature, recreation of Jurassic Park.
Yeah, no, bud, so what if they try and eat you? They're, like, the size of teacups. It's, like, all they can do is just, like, gum you to death.
Yeah, just nibble on your pinky a bit, maybe tear it off. Don't worry about it. You'll lose your pinky. It's
probably be the same as you'll lose your, actual pet. Dog or a pet cat bit you, it would be painful. It might draw blood, but it wouldn't be like life threatening.
You smack it on the nose, you tell it no, and then you let it go play. Like,
well, and you know, and that brings up an interesting idea. Like, so some of the most intelligent animals on the planet are actually birds, and compared to humans, their brains are remarkably small. But some birds, like the raven family or the blackbirds. They have
the blackbirds.
Why has it got to be black?
Don't even talk about the blackbirds.
Whoa,
what's wrong with the blackbirds?
Exactly.
I don't know. It's just the way he said it. It looks like they were like offending him.
What was I saying? Oh, their intelligence. They are actually smarter than the average small child. Their intelligence is right around between
like
a 7-year-old and a 9-year-old.
Oh, wow. Okay, never mind. That's a little smarter. I was like, maybe a 2-year-old, a 3-year-old, you know?
No. A full-grown, member of the Raven family can, like, kick the pants off of a 3 or 4-year-old as far as problem solving.
To be honest, I don't doubt it. Like, I've seen how 2 and 3-year-olds...
human children are really dumb at first, you know? It takes a while before, you know, you learn a bunch of stuff. But the birds, they develop pretty quickly, and so, like, considering
the
that
birds.
These tiny little things, itsy-bitsy little brains can be that smart, like, if you had, like, a full-size dinosaur with a much bigger-sized brain, I mean, it's still small compared to humans, but big compared to birds, like, they could be really fucking clever.
Yeah, they could be pretty smart. Like,
it could actually be like the velociraptors in Jurassic Park, where the guy's like, clever girl.
Yeah.
And then he gets his face eaten off.
Exactly.
Exactly what relationships are.
Like, what?
And this is why
he's like clever girl.
This is why Nobod is single.
Has Nobod.
What? I think you were just trying to make a joke right there.
I was.
He was, and it failed.
It was a good effort, though. You know.
Wrong audience. My bad.
Wrong audience.
You know, a good comedian knows his audience. You are, by definition, a bad comedian.
Oh. I think we all have our times in the spotlight where we make a decent joke. No, I do certainly understand. I think all of us on some level aren't like hilarious all the time. But
I've never made a decent joke. You know. But then I never try to be funny.
I mean, I've made a few good jokes here and there, just a few, you know, maybe, you know. Just
and wait, taking wait, Zach from the call.
Zach, why did your voice get all high and squeaky?
Because, you know.
Bees?
Please, bees? No, but, yeah, I think, you know, no bod's a hit or miss. That's like everybody here, except for, you know, maybe Mr. Fusion. He's got a good batting average. Ha-ha! Sports reference for Mr. Fusion. You're welcome.
I don't get it. What does he have to do with sports?
God damn it.
You know, I just think Mr. Fusion should start a sports podcast or something. He does know a lot about sports.
Exactly. Okay, good. So you redeemed yourself, because I was about to get on my high horse or soapbox and be like, here I am defending you, stepping up
here
to the plate.
Here I am.
Once again.
Before we get too far away from it, I just wanted to read the last four tiers.
Oh, sure.
Oh, that's still. Oh, yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, it's still going up.
Oh, wow.
It's still going up.
Still?
$20,000 will let you run the show, making this donation a once in a lifetime opportunity to help map out the entire scene in the first ever sex tape in space.
So you'll be like
positions,
coordinating with the director?
Finally.
Yes, positions, yes. Scripting. The whole shebang.
Someone please tell the someone slap the director with their penis every time he tries to do a goddamn under the ball shot. Can we all agree that the under the ball shot
Agreed.
Is not necessary?
You don't Agreed. Like watching balls slapping?
No one. No. Well, okay, I don't like that scene.
No one. Wait.
I think on average, I would say that most people who watch porn don't watch ball slapping, or at least that angle, the under the ball angle.
Yeah. Do gay people like ball slapping?
I like the sound. I don't know so much about the
yeah.
See, everyone likes the sound.
The sound is nice.
The sound, because the sound happens anywhere.
Course, but the angle is just
like
weird.
Your body clapping for you. But where?
Exactly.
I'm okay with the angle. I'm okay with it. I don't have a problem with it. It's not my favorite, but I'm okay with it.
I think it should be phased out of existence, in my honest opinion.
Whoa.
You know.
Well, obviously there's
to be fair, Zach. You're looking for something else in a porn, I would think, than he's looking for.
True.
Like,
director's cut. Alternate scenes, or something.
I only watch porn with commentary. Sorry.
Exactly.
From the side angle.
In space.
Yeah.
Slow mo ball slapping in space with zero G effects. What
exactly?
With special guest Obama.
Yeah.
$30,000 will let you put your branding on our official spacesuits.
Oh, what?
What?
Can we do an Indiegogo campaign to raise $30,000 to
put our
TFT?
Yeah, TFT logo. It's just the TFT logo on their spacesuits.
We should totally do that.
Oh, man. It's like TFTopia space or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
Space,
that's how it ends. That's literally how it ends.
Just yeah, like, it just says I don't know. you could do that if you paid that much money. They'd have to do it.
Yep.
$50,000 will let you get to pick from one of the 10 custom made props show, which it doesn't seem quite as good.
I'll pass on the props. They're probably sticky.
And the last one is the Uranus tier, by the way.
The Uranus tier.
The last one is $150,000, which this top-level donation scores you one of the two spacesuits worn by our sextronauts, complete with underwear.
Nope. I'm good.
Plus a swag bag.
That's something a Japanese businessman would totally be into.
Yeah, could you sell that for, like, 1.5 million yen over in Japan? And that probably translate to like 250,000 or something like that. But you know, you still profit.
The exchange
right?
rate's not that extreme between the two.
Oh, no.
So Chaos, I have a question. If you
the
pay,
answer is no.
Shush your face. I'm not talking to you. So if you pay 150,000, do you get the two spacesuits plus underwear along with everything else, or do you just get the spacesuit and the underwear? Because
oh yeah, do they stack? Yeah, that's interesting.
The stacking ends at what they call the swag bag of stuff, which is just all their merchandise in the bag. The actual individual tiers, like you wouldn't get a call and a dinner and
that's
everything
bullshit.
Else. You choose which tier you're at.
No, see, if I'm gonna pay $150,000, I want to be able to get a call, a dinner, get their space suit.
A blowjob.
Pretty much a blowjob.
Yes.
Maybe a handy under the table while I wait for my appetizers at that dinner. And then I want to talk to them about the different things I got. And then I want to leave after I feel satisfied. I won't feel satisfied until I get all that. It doesn't stack.
That's like a house, dude. You could buy a really nice house in certain places.
Or you could buy a spacesuit.
With underwear.
Which won't do you any good except it was worn by a porn star.
Wait, has anybody seen... I'm totally like switching gears slightly again. Has anyone seen that preview? I think I posted a link to it. With Matt Damon, the
Martians.
Martian.
The Martian. Yes.
Yeah.
That looks so good.
It looks interesting, and you know what? Matt Damon's an all right actor, so we'll see what happens.
Ken is actually reading the book. Well, he's been reading the book for like the last like 2 years. He's really bad about reading, but
oh, I started been, that book too.
He's been reading the book, and he's like, I don't know how I feel about Matt Damon playing the main character. I'm like, Matt Damon's a really good actor. Like, I haven't read the book, but like just seeing what I saw in the preview, I'm excited to see this.
Actually, I read like into the first chapter, and it's really good. I like it.
Well, you've read less than Ken has been.
Oh yeah, I know. He let me look at it one night, and I was like, oh, let me pick this up, and I didn't want to give it back to him. Yeah.
Okay. Well, you know, we'll see what happens. It could be a good movie.
I'm going to say, you know, sometimes you can see a preview and be like, okay, that movie's going to be shit, or hey, that's got a lot of promise. I think that this movie is actually going to be good. Based off of what I've seen, I'm going to say it's going to be good.
Talking about other movies and things based on stuff, anyway, they're going to be remaking or rebooting League of Extraordinary Gentlemen.
So I've heard.
Oh, hell yes. I fucking love that movie.
I liked it a lot too. Some other people, however, do not like it at all.
I will admit it's
and it didn't do too well in the box office.
No, yeah, it's not a particularly good movie, but it's got a lot of pizzazz and personality to it.
Yes, it does have it's campy and cheesy in certain places, and it's got its own personality, which
but
I thoroughly enjoy.
It's got Sean Connery in it.
Sean Connery.
Well, if they do a reboot
and that vampire
sure
chick, whatever her name is, she was so
that
cool.
That vampire chick. The one from Twilight?
No,
Dorian
dumbass.
Gray.
Yeah, her.
There's Dorian Gray, which is, he's a cool literary
Him.
Character.
Yeah, whatever.
The vampire chick, I can't remember. But yeah, there were a lot of cool characters involved.
And it
like,
had the guy from 30,000 Leagues Under the Sea, and
he had
a magnificent beard and mustache.
And you had to have the beard.
Exactly, and his boat, or his submarine thing, was freaking cool. It was all shiny and pretty.
I'm okay with them rebooting this. I was not okay with them rebooting Spider-Man because it's just more of the same, but I am okay with them doing this.
Whoa.
Like,
we'll see on Spider-Man. Hold on now. They're not doing his origin story again.
What do you want me to hold on to?
Your beer?
Got it.
Okay, cool. Alright, now that you're holding on to your beer, it's not a reboot of the character entirely. Like, I've been looking into that because I like Spider-Man a lot, but I've figured... I do. Tons, actually.
Awesome. We're going to get along great.
Would you have sex with Spider-Man in space?
Yes, I would, actually. So,
yeah, actually, yes.
Like, it's supposed to be just the introduction to his character. Then after that, it's supposed to be straight story, no reboot. We all know Uncle Ben kicked the bucket. Aunt May was sad as shit. He did a Spider-Man thing. But it's no more storytelling of his origin. So if they stick to that, then I'll be happy. But if it's a reboot, then yes, I'm right on board with you. It's gonna be fucking.
Well,
terrible.
Wait, are they gonna do like the 3-minute recap at the beginning of the movie? Like this stuff happened, and let's go.
No, it's more like they're introducing him in Civil War, so they're actually introducing him once Spider-Man is like an already well known character.
Wait. Okay, so wait, if he's gonna be in Civil War, is Fox still? Was it Fox?
Sony.
It was Sony. No, Sony doesn't own. No, Sony doesn't own Spider-Man anymore.
That's right,
Marvel
Fox
bought him
owned
back.
X-Men. Really? Okay, yeah. So never mind. I take back my cynicism. I didn't realize that Marvel bought them back.
They actually signed a deal with them, and they like Marvel pretty much like bottlenecked them into a contractual agreement saying, you'll let us do what we want with our character and let us have our creative ideals and do what we want. You can still reap some of the benefits, but the character and the rights to what he does is ours now.
Yeah,
and they pretty much
right
threw
now.
So much money up at him, and they had him, backed into a corner contractually. They were like, oh, fine, okay. So he is their character
again. They basically
again.
just just kept pushing them until they couldn't be pushed anymore. Marvel 1.
Yeah, now that Marvel is owned by Disney, they've got that Disney money, so like they're pretty much unstoppable.
Yeah, exactly. They're just a juggernaut.
Though I'm still curious as to how 20th Century Fox is still able to have the X-Men. Like,
I actually read something about that last week. Marvel is also putting a chokehold on all their production. Do you want to know why they haven't? Why we haven't seen any cool ass toys or really like merchandising for X-Men or Fantastic Four? Every single thing that comes out, like Marvel has been slowly saying no, cut production, no, cut production. That's why there's been no toys and Happy Meals. That's why there's not a lot of clothes. That's why there's not a lot of backpacks. They're like they're stopping everything one by one merchandising wise.
They want their property back.
They do.
I don't blame them.
And it's just been like a big dip swinging competition ever since. But now it's starting to hit because there was a super, super highly articulated and wonderful looking collection of X-Men figurines that were going to come out for the collectors. And just recently, Marvel told, I think, Kotaku Studios, the people who make all the super cool action figures, don't quote me on this. But they told them, no, you halt production, like post haste. Don't. I said don't. I have a disclaimer. I disclaim myself. They told them pretty much like, don't do it. No, we're done. So now everything they had on production lines, stop, done. Fox will get no fucking money. And that's why Fantastic Four has been like out of the limelight for the past, since that movie.
No shit. Yeah. Well, you know what? The preview I saw of the new Fantastic Four movie actually looked pretty good, especially compared to the old one.
Oh, yeah.
Like, what's up with that then? If Marvel still doesn't own Fantastic Four, like,
I mean, Fox, they're trying. I mean, arguably they're trying because Days of Future Past and First Class were all right. So
they figured
out like,
they have to step up their game with Marvel, like doing the whole Disney Renaissance thing.
Mm-hmm. So now they're slowly but surely trying to do the same thing. We'll just see if it catches steam. But that's why you haven't seen any of their shit on the shelves lately. Marvel is slowly getting their characters back.
That's cool.
Good for them.
Yeah.
I want to say they deserve it, but it's they're their characters. Like, yeah, they should have their own characters back.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Especially with Spider-Man blowing up in the Marvel community, like comic-wise, he just got five or six new runs.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah, he got the new Spider-Man, you have Ultimate Spider-Man Spider-Gwen, then you have Silk, then you have the Scarlet Spider.
Wait, Spider-Gwen?
Yeah, this...
Spider-Gwen.
This Tell like, me about Spider-Gwen.
If Peter Parker died, pretty much, instead of... instead of Gwen Stacy.
Wait, so does Gwen Stacy have Spider-Man's powers?
Yes.
Yeah, she takes over the mantle, basically.
How did she get his powers?
It's probably explained in the comic. I really wanted to read the first issue because it actually looks really good and her costume's really sick.
I did read the first issue, actually. It is really good. All those kids went to that same school and they all went on fucking field trips to Oscorp. Go figure. Everyone has the same enemy. But yes, you know, Parker died instead of Gwen.
Parker died, and then Gwen got bit by the spider or something, basically, right?
And yeah, and then out of guilt and all that kind of stuff, she decided to pick up the mantle, and then she has that whole, I have
so
to
So is
hide.
It like an alternate timeline?
It is an alternate timeline story.
Okay.
Are you saying, in this timeline, Parker was never bit?
Yeah, Parker was never bit at all.
Parker wasn't bit because Parker was too busy being dead.
Yeah,
and too busy.
Well, I didn't know if that meant like Spider-Man, him as Spider-Man had died, and then she had gotten bit separately later, which would have been kind of funny.
Nah, nothing like that. But the first issue, like, was just like a one shot. It was supposed to be a one thing for the whole Spider multiverse that was going on.
People really liked it.
Mm-hmm. And people just hopped on, and they were like, "We're gonna see more of her, right? Right? Right?"
Yeah.
And Marvel said,
"Yeah,
yes."
Cool. Well, that's I was kind of like I love Peter Parker. He's my favorite Spider-Man and always will be. But I would have loved to see Miles Morales as Peter, the Spider-Man that's introduced into Civil War.
Wait, who's Miles?
Miles.
He's the one of the Ultimates, right?
Yes, he's from the Ultimate Universe, the universe that Marvel is making their movies from.
So I haven't met Miles yet.
Not yet.
Not yet. But basically, this is from a timeline where he gets bit by an Oscorp spider that his uncle stole from Oscorp. And he witnesses Peter Parker's death, protecting Aunt May from the Green Goblin.
And the actual Death of Spider-Man comics, yeah, you find that out.
Exactly, in the Death of Spider-Man, yeah. And he sort of, like, he understands with great power comes with great responsibility, and that if he actually went and helped Peter Parker when he was fighting Green Goblin, Peter Parker and Spider-Man would have both lived. So he takes on that mantle and becomes the next Spider-Man.
So that's kind of like his tragic story then, too.
Exactly.
Also, his really mother gets murdered in the hospital by Venom. There's that, too.
Now, that's just a little excessive.
Nah,
okay?
He rips that bitch to pieces in the fucking ER after she has, like, a panic attack. Like, oh my god, my son is Spider-Man! He's like, Mom, we have to get you to the hospital. So he takes her there, and, you know, chaos is breaking loose, and obviously Venom tracks Spider-Man no matter where. He's like, oh,
and he's like, oh, your mom is here. Well, guess what? Your mom's dead now.
Pretty much. Yeah. To pieces. Eviscerated.
Yeah.
This is why I like Venom. And why I hated Venom in the third Spider-Man movie.
Yeah.
Because he was just so stupid. Like, Venom is like
cool.
Evil.
Venom's supposed,
like,
to be huge.
Yeah, Venom is like evil. Like, he does terrible, horrible things, like, make you want to, like, cringe and cry on the inside. Like,
he's like the anti-Spider-Man. He's
pretty much.
Well, I mean, he is portrayed that way in the movie, just, you're saying it's like a dumbed down or, like, not a scary.
He doesn't
do
anything! It's like, and then he's got that stupid, whatever the other guy's name was, the actor there, it's like,
Topher Grace?
He seemed, to me, just like, Peter Parker, when he was doing his emo thing, he seemed just like that, only a little bit more douchey.
Yeah.
I would have loved, like, a huge no-name, just, like, stunt double of this just big-ass, like, 6'8".
That's what I was thinking. Like, just get a dumb, ugly, blonde motherfucker and put him in there who can do cool stuff.
Are you saying blonde people
are
ugly?
Did you just turn black all of a sudden?
Yes, I did, actually. I was saying blonde because Eddie Brock is actually blonde. He was a big, ugly, blonde motherfucker who lifted weights all day and was super angry.
Yeah.
What made him ugly?
He was super angry at Spider-Man because Eddie Brock blamed Spider-Man for having his job getting taken away by the Daily Bugle.
Yeah.
So
that's kind of a really lame story.
And got really strong, and then all of a sudden he met the symbiote Venom, and then they became best buds. And, like, let's kick Spider-Man's ass and kill him and eat him for breakfast. And they high fived and made out, and then they went on their mission.
Pretty much what happened.
You know what? I would watch that porn.
I think there is a porn for that, actually, and I stumbled upon
it
accidentally.
That sounds sexy to me.
That you know what? Sure, why not?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, you would be the right person to ask. I don't know if I asked you this before or not. How do you feel, Malcolm, about Thor now being, not She-Thor, but a woman being Thor? Like, that whole change that they've made there.
I'm cool.
I am actually completely okay with it.
Now, how are they doing that? I understand it's happening, but I don't understand how.
Actually, Thor has died. Thor... You know, Ragnarok happened. That's one of the major comic events that happened. You know, Ragnarok, thing that they were constantly talking about, oh my god, the end of
is
our
world.
Is he the
purple guy?
I think, no, that's Galacticus. Or that's Thanos. Like, purple skin or purple outfit? Which one? Purple skin or outfit?
The CG guy that's purplish.
Oh no, that's Thanos.
Thanos. Yeah. That's all the Infinity Gauntlet thing.
Okay. Yeah.
So, pretty much, Ragnarok happens, like, the actual cataclysmic event.
What is Ragnarok?
Nordic.
Is it in any of the movies?
It is in the movies. It's in the Thor movies. They're talking about Ragnarok in the second Thor movie. Ragnarok is supposed to happen in the actual one that's coming out in 2 years.
Okay. Yes. I'll just have to wait 2 years to figure out what the fuck you're talking about then.
So,
continue.
So that happens. Go on.
I'm sorry. But basically, Ragnarok is the end of days, apocalyptic thing in Norse mythology and, for all intents and purposes, in Marvel. Just so we clear that up.
Yeah.
Any confusions in the chat.
So that's what Ragnarok is. It happens, Thor dies, and the spell is whoever, you know, shall be worthy to possess this hammer will gain the power of Thor. I'm paraphrasing. I can't remember the exact, actual quote.
That's pretty close.
Yeah. So it turns out that one of the people who was worthy is one of the people that put up with Thor's bullshit for years, stood by his side for years, you know, dedicated her life for a period of time to his cause and the Avengers for years, someone who was noble in spirit, and it just so happened to be his ex-girlfriend, Jane Foster. So
wait, ex-girlfriend? So they break up?
Oh yeah, they broke up.
Oh, in the comics.
In the comics, yes. Yeah, in the comics, they're no longer a thing. So, you know, she kind of gets...
Try to be the spouse of a superhero, man. Can you imagine?
Yeah, try to be the spouse of a demigod who leaves for, like, years at a time.
That would be annoying.
Yeah.
Okay.
So she puts up with all of his shit. Eventually, she's like, no, Thor, I can't do it. After all the shit that went down, I almost died. You almost died. Fuck this. I can't do it. He dies. The hammer says, I like the jib of that Jane Foster chick. And then it flies on over to her. Boom! She gets it. The catch is, she has cancer. I haven't read too much of it.
What?
Yeah, no.
What? But anytime, wait, how does that...
Anytime she has the hammer, she's cancerless. She's super-duper badass She-Thor. But as soon as that goes away, she's cancer-ridden Jane Foster.
So she can't put the hammer down she'll die?
No, she can put it down. She'll just live like any other human with cancer. She'll make it or she won't.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, that's what I mean. She has to put down, she has to keep the hammer or she'll have a chance of dying.
Pretty much, yes. Because with the hammer.
That seems really terrible.
It is, which makes you wonder.
Like a drama to it.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, like, but though, imagine if you, like, need to sleep or something like that. Like, would you have to, like, chain it to yourself?
No, I mean, so long as she holds the hammer, so she can keep it in her possession, she can stay Thor, which I'm thinking that'll be a story arc later on. Like, to avoid her inevitable upcoming death. Like, she just won't let the hammer leave her side at all.
She's like, I don't feel like dying anytime soon, so I'm just gonna, like, duct tape the hammer to my hand, so...
Well, that, and that means, like, if she got to the point where the cancer was getting even worse and, you know, about to die, and she, like, picked up the hammer to save herself, and she's fighting an enemy, and then they knock the hammer away.
And then she dies!
Like, instantly.
That's how Thanos killed one of the original Thors in the actual Infinity Gauntlet comics. He goes, oh, you need the hammer? Cool. He takes it himself, actually, he makes a portal. When, like, he throws it at him, sends it to the opposite side of space, so then the hammer's just floating endlessly and will take forever to get back. And then as Thor changes and, like, goes back to his little human form, he just starts to suffocate without the hammer. Yeah. And he's like, yep.
Oh, that's like, so sad for him.
Right? He's like, yeah, you need that hammer, don't you, bitch? Move. I'm killing the rest of the Avengers now.
Oh, and apparently Mr. Wartburg, who's read up on the comics, says that the hammer is making the cancer worse.
Oh.
So it's like a cure, but like with a curse as well.
Yeah, that's
pretty, you can't that's put the cure down.
Yeah,
don't stop the cure. Sorry,
that's interesting.
Yeah, it would probably like that would mean it would just accelerate the rate that it's developing so very quickly after like a decent time of being Thor. Then it'd be suddenly you can't not be Thor at all.
She either gets cured or she dies and the mantle passes on. That's like how comics go, right?
Pretty much, but the thing is, they went through all this big change, these big changes. I mean, you know, Spider-Man, there's two of them now. We have Miles Morales and Peter Parker. We have a black Captain America. We have
Falcon.
Black Falcon / Captain America. We have a Middle Eastern Miss Marvel. Tony Stark is back again, and his armor does all kinds of crazy weird shit, so he might as well be a new character. I mean, like, everything has totally changed. So,
which is cool.
It is. It's good for an overhaul. DC did the same thing, but theirs was nowhere near as interesting.
Yeah, well, you know, considering how old the Marvel Universe is and how far technology and society has progressed in the last 30, 40, 50 years, it makes sense that they would need a drastic overhaul of these characters to just kind of bring them, like, fully into the modern world.
Very true. I like how a lot of the different X-Men are coming out as, like, homosexual, too. Like, different ones, just here and there.
Really? Are they?
Colossus, Big Metal Man, he does not like women. Yeah. His relationship with Kitty Pryde went out the window. Iceman, very recently found out he was homosexual.
What?
Are these all in the comics?
Yeah, these
wait, did you say Pride Man?
Iceman.
Oh, I just said Pride
Man. Mystique obviously has had relations with males and females in the past.
Let's just say she's pansexual. Implied.
Yeah, Mystique is pansexual. And like,
or bisexual. You know, that's a thing.
Yeah, true.
Very true. So, I mean, like, different mutants here and there are coming out as, you know, straight, lesbian, gay, pansexual, bisexual. It's cool how they change the agenda from racism to now the LGBT community.
Yeah.
Like, I like how the X-Men always can fit some particular, what's the word, social...
Oh yeah, like that's
social
exactly
taboo.
Why
yeah.
I enjoyed the X-Men as much as I did, and especially when the first couple movies came out, because the world was definitely a different place. It totally was not legal to get married if you wanted to marry someone of the same sex as you. That's the whole reason why I really fell in love with the whole idea of the X-Men, and it in and of itself is just the drastic amount of shit that you have to deal with.
I think
the bigotry and the moronicness.
Exactly. I think anyone who's had to experience being an outcast in society identifies with the X-Men, you know? Like,
and that's why they're so universal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For real.
I definitely have to say that. So yes, Tom, just in case you didn't know that, they've been doing that with different X-Men characters over the years. Iceman was just one of the biggest one because he's had relations with multiple different X females, but it turns out that there's a straight one and there's a gay one or whatever. Due to parallel timeline stuff in comics, there's one who has never had relations with women. and then there's the one that has.
Get over here and let me have relations with you.
Mm-hmm. Or I'll freeze you to death. Aww.
So, are they making a new X-Men movie?
Yes, yeah. Age of Apocalypse. Hey, all I'm saying is from everything that I've seen, they're staying pretty loyal to the comical adaptations of the characters. I mean, the chick who's playing Storm is even shaving her head to go all fully mohawk so she can fill the 80s role of Storm.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Wait a minute, is it taking place in the 80s?
Yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh, dude, it's a period piece.
It is.
And
mutants. It's a period piece.
And it's mutants. Like, how can you go wrong?
And it has Egypt and Apocalypse. Yeah, exactly. You have, like, the
but
four
thing with Egypt.
Of
you're always
movie.
Egypt when we play Civ.
Egypt's amazing, dude.
Egypt is amazing.
What is so great about Egypt? I don't
Apocalypse, pyramids, and they're good at waging war.
Exactly.
And their art is fucking fantastic.
Yeah.
Have you seen it?
If you like looking at people with their heads painted sideways.
I do. And then I like the giant gold idols that look like jackals and dogs. It's swanky. I dig it. If I could have my house like that, I'd do it.
Yeah.
They're also big on, like, you know, sex all the time.
Right?
Everywhere.
Are they?
Like, yeah.
I'd want to have a balcony on my pyramid
but,
so
you know,
I can have
with,
sex
with
all
their
day.
Brothers and sisters, though. So.
Whoa,
with everybody.
Wow. Those are just small details that don't matter.
Idiosyncrasies. Well, all idiosyncrasies. Let's not worry about it.
Okay, sure.
Don't think too hard about it.
Just be too hard about
it. Okay, well.
Be hard.
Hey!
Oh! Well, while we're... What's kind of related to sex. It's about testicles.
Oh, God.
I saw, all right. I saw this study earlier this week, and I think it finally explained to me why mammals have external testicles, because it's never made any sense to me up until now. Right? So, you ever think about it? It doesn't make much sense. Like, you know, they're just kind of sitting there, dangling, waiting to get kicked by someone, you know, and like, even if, you know, men tend to be a little bit more stronger and everything. Yeah, but still, like, there are these delicate little things that are dangling outside of your body, and you're like, why? So, apparently... This was a study about why humans have the body temperature that they have. And as we all know, it's around, what is it,
98.6.
It varies from person to person, but it's 98.something for most people. So apparently early mammals evolved this high body temperature to help combat fungal infections, what you see affecting plants a lot, and it sometimes affects like reptiles and other cold-blooded creatures. They get these fungal infections. But when you have a higher body temperature, fungus does not grow so well. So by having a higher body temperature, we are actually excluded from this entire category of terrible things that can happen to you. Then again, if your body temperature is too high,
you wind up
burning too much energy, and you know it's kind of a self-destructive cycle. But the temperature, that 98 point whatever, is the perfect balance between burning enough energy and staying just warm enough to combat fungus. that it's just that Goldilocks zone. So that got me thinking. I'm like, that must be why we have external testicles then, because like reptiles and everything, they're cold-blooded, internal testes. But then in your testicles are supposed to be colder than your internal body temperature. And again, logically, that makes no sense. Like, why would you have an organ in your body that is supposed to be colder than the rest of your body? Otherwise, it doesn't work right. But suddenly it all makes sense. It's like if we actually had evolved this capability to combat fungus by raising our body temperature, then we would need to move those organs outside so they don't get damaged. Yeah, it's like, finally, thank you, science. I have an explanation. I just needed to say that because I've been thinking about that like for the earlier part of this week, and it just kind of blew my mind. So there you go. You're welcome.
Testicles. I took my pants off, so now I feel great.
Well, all right.
What?
All right. I thought you had another story.
That's two of us out of all of us here that doesn't have pants on right now. Who's gonna join us next?
Well, come on. I have my Taiwanese fisherman pants.
Those are fucking awesome. So, okay, you don't have to be pantsless. Those are comfortable enough.
Pretty much. So I bought these pair of pants that are called Taiwanese fisherman pants, and they are by far some of the most comfortable articles of clothing to, like, bless my lower half that ever has. It's just, it's, like, breezy. I've worn it on, like, a 96, you know, degree day, and it just feels like there's nothing there. And that's with, you know, boxers and the whole shebang. It's
great.
They
look like they're, like, three to five sizes too big.
But work so well.
They're like one size fits all, aren't they?
They're literally one size fits all. A guy who I probably could have, I'm not being mean, but I probably could have fit like three and a half of me to make him, and he wore these pants. And I was like, what the shit? Dude, give me.
Give me now.
Here, let me pull up a link. So yeah,
my boys were getting strangulated in my Hollister jeans, and I'm like, I need something a little more breezy. Yeah.
No,
like,
Hollister, like Abercrombie
skinny jeans.
Bitch.
Yeah, skinny Taiwanese jeans are fun to look at because they cup everything, but fuck, are they uncomfortable?
Skinny jeans. I just wear straight like boot cut mostly. And, I mean, they're well fitting because they're designer jeans, but still, my God, I need room to breathe down there.
You do. It's a necessity.
Down where? I don't get it.
Nah.
What? What don't you get?
I said down where? I don't get it.
Down? Okay. Well.
He wouldn't understand.
Nobot's actually a robot.
I'm a robot.
So it does not compute.
Yeah.
Okay, there's a link for you guys. I found one for Etsy. Yeah.
Link dump.
Yeah, I think I'm going to have to buy mine from here. I'm going to get a pair of shorts next.
A link! You know where that goes? Link dump. Huh. Crazy.
The internet.
Oh, that's right. He is the one editing this podcast. Well, let's hope it makes it into the link dump.
I hope it makes it into the link dump. That has to be shared with everybody.
Exactly.
Chaos is really good about the link dump. It's like he's a pro, but Wubwave, he's not so much.
Yeah. Hey, he's getting there. It's fine. I just like teasing him about it.
To be fair, it's just happened for the switchover. Like, Mr. Fusion doing all the fusion thing only happened after 100.
Yeah, that's you know, it takes some time to get used to it, but, you know,
yeah,
when you make
what
a...
I'm hearing is excuses.
Dark, I love you.
Wow.
I love you so much. No, but, yeah, I mean, you know, it's whatever. I love you, Wubwave. Don't hit me. These pants do look freaking amazingly comfortable.
They are. The best part is they come in so many different styles. Yeah, you can wear them publicly. I mean, I don't wear them everywhere because I only have one pair right now, so that'd be slightly unsanitary, and I don't want to wear them out by washing them all the time.
Yeah.
So, I mean, they work. They're functional. They're comfy, and they're functional, and that's all I look for in life.
It's like anything that you can wear and not have to wear underwear underneath it is a win.
Oh, like
book.
Sweatpants.
Exactly.
Let's all agree sweatpants are amazing.
No.
What?
I'm sorry.
I like sweatpants.
I like sweatpants.
Not
sweatpants are awesome.
Sweatpants because okay. I don't
okay,
know.
No,
are these because we're white?
I've been scarred by sweatpants. Oh, okay.
Just wearing lounge pants.
Yeah, we're not talking about those people that go to Walmart in their sweatpants.
Yeah.
Or that old fat guy that touched you while
wearing
sweatpants
and it feels just as comfortable as not wearing pants.
This is true. Okay, never mind.
Like, the shorts I'm constantly wearing, they're like sweatpants that are cut off just above the knee, and I never wear underwear with those because they're so super comfy, but I don't wear them outside.
I kind of want to steal those from you, I'm not going to lie, but
you
I haven't.
You can't have them.
They look comfy. I want them.
They are comfy,
but
you can't have them.
It's fine. Whatever. Cool. Anyway.
Oh, that resentment just came out right there. Three words.
Okay, all right, whatever.
On the topic of random topics, has anyone heard about the actual Powerpuff Girls reboot that's happening?
No.
Yes, I have.
And how they did not contact not a one fucking single voice member for any of the Powerpuff Girls to reprise their roles.
Well, didn't they all pretty much sound the same squeaky, Tara Strong voice?
They did, but I'm just saying they didn't even contact Tara Strong back.
Yeah.
Well, no, well, what's this story? Is it like in the future...
I mean, it's
after, you know, years after the show where the voices would sound older.
I mean, if that's the case, then they should change the art design. But
style. Are they just doing a complete reboot with the same art style but updated animation, so it's not like that grainy or grainy?
Boom! Exactly what you said.
Okay.
But then they didn't get the same voice, so it's like they look the same. They look better, but you got the narrator, the guy who does the mayor, which is SpongeBob, and somebody else to come back for the roles, but you did, like, it wasn't like they chose
them
and they're
ask?
Like, no thanks, we have other things. No, yeah, they didn't even ask. They weren't even like, hey guys, we're doing a reboot.
That's...
and it's gonna look amazing and we would love to have you come
back.
Well,
have you heard the new voices? Maybe they can mimic how the other people sound pretty close.
I mean, yeah, they're probably wanting
to go in their own direction and not be, you know, if they sound exactly the same, then it'll probably be weird if they go their own direction. So I can see why they would choose a different voice actor.
Is it an English reboot?
Well, yeah.
Oh, yes, it is. It's
no,
not like...
it's in Taiwanese.
It's not like Japanese
Supernatural.
Yeah, exactly. I was about to say something stupid,
and then I completely
forgot that. Was Powerpuff Girls originally anime, or
no? It wasn't.
It was just a straight up Cartoon Network. Okay, fair enough.
Yeah, it was one of Cartoon Network's like gems of the 90s because they had a lot of shit then. But Powerpuff Girls was actually really good.
I love Powerpuff Girls. I loved Courage the Cowardly Dog.
Courage the Cowardly Dog. I would love for a Courage the Cowardly Dog reboot with
There's a movie that's been crowdfunded that they're working on right now.
For Courage the Cowardly Dog.
Yeah.
Oh fuck yeah!
Is it a 3D? Is it a cartoon?
It's like this interesting sort of 3D cel shaded. It looks good. It looks good, and it's gonna
So like a Borderlands 2 Courage
basically
thing.
Yeah, but it's gonna be like very hyper stylized and all the same voices and the voice actors are gonna be
what I loved about Courage the Cowardly Dog is that they were not afraid to go to some really
dark
uncomfortable
places.
Oh my god,
show.
Return like, the Slug.
Oh, I was about
fucking
to
hated
stop,
that episode
dude.
Oh my god,
that episode
they even
gave
had
me
an
nightmares.
Episode about Yeah, they had an episode about, like, I don't want to say it's spousal abuse, but it's like celebrities that beat their partners. Yeah. They had an episode about that. It was
the big dog guy and the cat lady.
Oh,
yeah,
never mind, not that one.
The big dog and the cat, exactly.
Yeah, that one was also about prostitution.
Yes, it was.
I'm like, holy shit. Yeah. Like, they went there, and they did a really good job. That's the thing. Like, if you go there, you have to know your shit.
Yeah,
and they totally
disturbing...
owned it. They did a great job.
You know what I never got?
On handling that.
Fred the barber.
Hmm.
Like, he just cut.
Oh my god,
like,
yes.
He just cut hair. Why is he insane?
He has a haircutting fetish. I mean, but some fetishes can be taken too far. I mean, he obviously physically restrained people against their will to shave them bald. And, like,
that,
you saw him do that with...
Okay, now that you say...
Wait, he was the one that was,
naughty.
Yes, okay, yes. Okay.
Oh, so,
and then I learned that I like to be...
Naughty.
Yes.
It's been forever since I've seen these episodes.
Go to Netflix, dudes. Go to Netflix, Courage the Cowardly Dog.
It's such a good show. And what's weird, like, Courage the Cowardly Dog reminds me of a hybrid between American animation and anime in a way, like with the background.
Yeah.
So you know how in anime the backgrounds are super detailed?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And they totally did that. Like, they have these, like, the wallpaper and everything in the house is like, I don't know, it must have been done in CG because it looks like real wallpaper, like slapped on there with these animated.
No,
characters.
They used real wallpaper.
No, they didn't. You can tell it's not actually real, but it is so super detailed. I'm like, what the
Oh, you didn't
hell?
Know Courage the Cowardly Dog is a live action?
Yeah. Live action show.
Oh my god,
it's a live action
audience.
Film. Could you imagine? That'd be funny. Mr. Like, Katz was
I have
also
to say
a
the
shit.
I love Mr. Katz. One episode that always fucked me up as a child was the were-moles. Because we had moles in our yards.
Oh, no.
So, no, because we used to have those big mole heels.
Scared of moles.
And I would see, like, the burrowing holes under the ground. Yeah. So I'm like, oh, my God, if I go outside at night to take out the trash, they're going to fucking kill me.
They're
going to
bite
me. They're
going to bite me.
Scared of the
were-mole, man.
I was like, oh, what do I do? I was like, can you watch me? Watch you what? Take out the trash. Boy, go take the trash out. No.
I'm scared.
There's moles out there, Mom.
You're going to rip my feet off and flip me around and pull me in a hole. Don't you want your son to live?
Don't you? You're scared of the wimpiest thing.
Hey, that's what he was
Well,
a kid.
It all depends on what time you saw them.
I
like,
saw them at the
even
age of
though
like seven.
You know something's purely fictional, it doesn't mean that if you, especially if you see certain things younger, that you're going to like slightly turn your back or turn around your head at night.
The show is super creepy. So, you know what? Yeah, if
that too.
Yeah.
I would if I were
7 years
you know,
old
your
watching
age,
the Weremole.
Yeah, when I watched
if I
would
was your
been,
age,
I would have been
7
too.
Though.
Another one was the mermaid episode. That was a good one. Mermaid? The siren. The one that would drag Eustace down through like the bathtub drain and like try to take him under in like that giant water reserve underneath their house.
So she could rape him?
Pretty much. Rape him and steal his life.
Who understands the motivation of sirens anyway?
Exactly.
No one really.
Poseidon.
To alert people.
Poseidon, yeah, fair enough.
That's it though.
Yeah.
That's all I got.
The duck god episode was pretty interesting. Was it the goose? Was it a goose? Or,
yeah.
Yeah, it was a goose god.
The goose?
Right, it was a goose.
It was not a duck.
It's a goose?
Not.
Dear gosh.
Not a duck.
Like, there was a point in time where I was like marathoning episode. I watched a lot of these references I don't even get. Like, there was so much of that show. It's so
David,
awesome
you need
episodes.
To watch more cartoons, okay?
So
just
no, I want no, see, that's the thing. Of all the cartoons, like, the period of time of the Powerpuff Girls, Courage Cowardly Dog, Ed and Eddie, like all those shows of that Cartoon
Rocky
Network,
Power,
I watched.
Yeah,
like, a
Ed
lot
and Eddie was really good too.
Ed,
my sister hated it, but
yeah,
I loved
Ed and Eddie. It was great.
They did have a couple episodes that were really, really terrible, but most of them were pretty damn good.
Yeah, they were. I love Plank. He was my favorite character.
I can't remember.
And Johnny 2x4?
Johnny 2x4.
It's like, Plank's gone insane! I loved that episode.
Yeah.
Plank is a serial killer.
There were some great episodes, and I felt like that show, even though there weren't too many morals there, like to be learned, there were. You know what I mean?
Don't be a douchebag. No. Don't scam the neighborhood friends.
Yeah.
And
brush. Have some hygiene. You know, like
Have some hygiene.
Save your money for them gobstoppers.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Learn that no means no from the Canker Sisters.
Like
jawbreakers.
Yeah,
jawbreakers.
That's it. The jawbreakers.
Yeah.
Like, they were the size of like
their
volleyballs,
heads?
And they would like stick them
no,
in their mouth, and they'd
their
just
heads.
Be this giant blob.
Dude,
sticking
they
out of their mouth,
like a jawbreaker, so bad. And then
they did,
and the fact that they like bounce them around, roll them around, like depending on the actual episode.
Like,
oh, yeah,
to
the,
me, that was
the entire
really creepy. Like the jawbreakers in Ed and Eddie universe was really
like
creepy.
They're the size of comet.
They would have actually
crazy huge.
Yeah, and they would like fight over the damn things. Like, really, guys? Like,
I used
there was an
have...
entire episode where Eddie he. He just gets a quarter, goes down to the store, buys a jawbreaker, and in the entire episode, he's just chasing it down the street.
I remember that one.
There was nothing
happening.
Yeah,
like a line of chickens or something like that, preventing him from getting
Ed
to the other place.
Chickens.
It was this big dramatic.
He's like, I love chickens.
Event.
Chickens, Eddie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And didn't like Kevin's dad work at the jawbreaker?
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Factory or like store or whatever, phone. Yeah.
It kind of taught me about drugs a little bit too.
Yeah.
Cuz like you will do anything to get your next fix.
Yeah, fair enough.
Cuz holy shit, did they go through some extreme things. Like
I can see that, actually.
Yeah, it's, well, like, or the fact that anything can become an addiction. How about that?
Yeah.
Like, that's, like, holy shit. They tried to steal, they lied, they fucking
they hustled.
Up, like,
they dug under Kevin's garage at one point to try to get inside to get the job records out.
Yeah, they lied to their parents, they lied to their, oh my, like, they did the worst shit.
Wait, how did they lie to their parents? The parents aren't even in the show.
There were a couple of times where I think Double D or Ed, Ed was grounded, and they would all, and they snuck out.
At least Double D, like, would communicate with his parents
sticky
by
note.
A sticky
yeah.
note.
See, that made sense. I always thought that was cool. I was like, oh, he actually talks to his parents. That's cool.
Hmm. Yeah, they just so happened to never actually be in the houses during the show. But
I completely would love a reboot of Ed, Edd n Eddy.
I don't know. I don't think it would really fit too well in
current...
I wish they would fucking finish Samurai Jack.
Oh, yeah!
I don't care what anyone says.
Yeah.
Suck my dick, Cartoon Network. Finish Samurai Jack.
Yeah.
About Shaolin...
Or Shaolin Showdown. Was... Oh!
Shaolin Showdown.
Orb of Toranami. Sorry.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Or Rocket Power.
Yeah. What? No. No, that's Nickelodeon. Get that shit out of here.
Nickelodeon.
What's that?
Oh, what's wrong with Rocket Power?
It was all right. I don't know. It wasn't...
Fun fact to know. Actually, does anybody know what Nickelodeon means?
No.
That was the originally came from... little devices which you would pay a nickel for, and it'd be a flip motion or stop motion like picture, like, you know, the flip books.
Oh.
Yeah, it wasn't wasn't so much a little device, but yeah, people would go to the Nickelodeon to watch moving pictures. So it was like a theater. Like, yeah, it was a place you would go to, the Nickelodeon.
Yeah, Real Monsters was pretty good. Cat Dog was pretty good.
Angry Beavers.
Angry Beavers was
Rocket
Powers.
Angry Beavers was amazing.
Was Ren and Stimpy on Nickelodeon?
Ren and Stimpy was Mad TV, yep. weren't they?
Mad TV. It was either Mad TV or Nickelodeon. I can't remember.
That's
was,
old
it
as
was Nickelodeon.
Shit.
Yeah. It was Nickelodeon.
What about that? Okay. The Meltman. Those stop motion action figures. Meltman with the power of melt. What the fuck? What is that show called?
Meltman used to freak me out.
Tree powers.
Yeah, yeah. Well, there were other ones, but Meltman just sticks to mind. What show is that called? Someone in the chat.
Was that Superhero High School or whatever?
Hold on.
Superhero High School.
Hold on.
Dude just melts.
Give me a minute.
He was like
Terry
a sidekick.
Give me
a
minute. Ren and Stimpy was on Nick.
Okay,
Kablam.
Google. What is Meltman from?
It was Kablam.
It's from Kablam?
We'll see.
I think so.
Meltman. The power to melt.
Was that the name of that SpaceX video?
And then there was like Sasquatch and Alien, like stop motion, like gray alien.
I remember that.
And then, yeah. Ah, oh, dude.
One of the cartoons that I think got a pretty decent send off would either be Rugrats or Hey Arnold from that era.
Oh yeah, dude. Rugrats.
I got too old for Rugrats. I have no idea how it ended.
How did Rugrats end?
Don't ask me. I don't remember. I just know it came to an end.
Tommy died.
No, I feel...
I know they had, like, 3 movies or something like that.
Oh, yeah, they did the Rugrats the movie, Rugrats Babies in Paris or something like that.
Yeah, Rugrats in Paris, and they had another
That was
one.
The first
They had a Rugrats and Wild Thornberry.
There was a Smell-O-Vision in theaters. Do you guys remember that? They had, like...
I do.
I remember that.
Wasn't it the Thornberries one that was in Smell-O-Vision? Well, Thornberries
Action
and Rugrats?
Action League Now.
Yeah, it was the Rugrats Thornberry.
From Action League Now.
Action League Now, that's right.
Action League Now, sick, okay. Action League Now, yeah, okay, thanks.
Oh shit, guys, I've got my phone open so I can actually see the time. We are at, it's 10:13, so we need to wrap this thing up.
All right.
Just like, we gotta wrap this up like a
wrap. Wrap it up!
Wrap it up like a condom?
Yes.
Okay.
What?
Don't be silly,
what's
sexually?
That?
Does anybody have anything that must be said before we... do the final speech.
Oh, I have one more thing. Dragon Ball Z Super comes out on July 5th. Holy fucking shit, I've been waiting for 18 years. Yes.
What's that?
The new Dragon Ball Z series. The one that's supposed to happen.
What's Dragon Ball?
I hate you.
Who said that?
I hate you.
Nobody. Just leave. Don't even disintegrate yourself. Just leave.
At least I'm not the only one that's constantly telling him to leave. I'm glad someone else gets that too.
So as I was saying, my dream of 18 years is finally happening, and the movie comes out in about 1 month as well. So we have a month to wait for the new movie and a month to wait for the new series. And there is a manga that is supposed to be following the actual adaptation of, like, the show. Oh, such happy.
A manga? Don't you mean an anime book?
Oh my! Get the fuck out!
Hey.
Go! Just get out! Damn it!
All right.
I'm trying, but you guys want to end the podcast.
All right. With that, let us bid everybody a farewell. Thank you, everybody, for listening tonight. If you're trying to locate us anywhere on our social networks, you can find us on Twitter at the Forum Thread. We've got a Facebook account. We're on roosterteeth.com, where we first evolved from. You can also listen to our podcasts on iTunes. So make sure you check out all that cool stuff, and also check us out on YouTube. And with that, we bid you all a good night. We will do this again next week, same time, same place. Good night, everybody.
Aloha.
Don't forget to make donations.
Aloha.
Aloha.
Yeah.